I've made a copy of ODB19 alias and sort, and I'm calling this one ODB20 QRY where. So far, all of our query examples have selected every record on the table. Now we're going to look at ways of filtering down our result set. Let's go into queries and open up the query from our last example. We'll open this up in design mode. Let's run the query by clicking on the Run Query icon. And we can see that we've got every record on our table, all 28 records. We want to limit this now to just select all the records from the accounting department. To do that, we need to put something in our criterion here under department. I will put in accounting, and when I hit enter, we'll see that single quotes go around the outsides of the accounting. Now, when I run this query, it limits it just to the accounting department. Let's see how this looks in SQL view. We've got our single line. I'll need to reformat that. Now this looks a little more familiar. We've got our select that we're already familiar with, from, and the order by. The new thing is this where clause, where department equals accounting. And the important thing to notice here is that accounting has single quotes, not double quotes. In an earlier video, we created a filter that would select only women from the IT department. Let's create that same filter here in design mode. I'm going to click back into design mode. I'm going to remove the group and add in a gender field. Now, if I just click right in this field cell, there's an arrow down. This gives me a choice of all the fields available. And you'll notice that it has the table name dot field name. If I was first to select the table, then click in the field. Now when I click this down arrow, I'm limited to all the fields on that table. Now this happens to be the same because we only have one table available at this time. So let's select gender. And now we want to add in our criteria of gender equals female. And our department now will equal IT. Hitting F5 to run it shows us the four females in the IT department. The same results we had when we created that filter. Let's look at the SQL for this. Again, we've got that single line. I'm going to reformat this. And with this formatted, it's easy to see our select, our from, our order by, and our new one, where department equals IT and gender equals female. Now what makes this significant is this is the same code that our filter had to create to give us those results. Well, not exactly the same code. In this code, we've added an alias and we've also added a sort, which might be different. But we can see how easy formatted SQL code is to understand. And we'll be using SQL code a lot more than we will any filter. That's why I barely mentioned it in the filters. Let's save this filter as ODB20 query IT female. Okay. Let's go back into design view. I'm going to come down and change gender back to group. Going to take off this criterion female as well as our criterion IT. I'm going to make our group criterion group C. Hitting F5 shows us that it's bringing up only the values for group C. Let's change this now to be group A, And down below the criterion, we have this or. So we want to make this group A or group D. Now when I hit F5, we see only group A or group D. Now to make this group C or group D, we could change this to be group C or group D, or I could take off this or and say all groups greater than group C will give us group D. Let's run that and show that. And because I forgot to hit enter or tab, it only gives us group C. We can say greater than group C. I must hit enter. Now if I hit F5, it's showing us only group D. I can change this to greater than or equal to group C will give us group C and group D. Hitting enter, then F5. We could also make this a less than. Less than group C should give us group A and B, which it does. And the last one we're going to try is make it all of the groups except group C. The way to do that is to say not equal to C. And we do that by using the exclamation point equals, means not equals group C. Hitting enter. And now F5. And we see groups A, B, and D, but no group C. And our last challenge will be to say not in group C and not in group A. Not equal to group A. I'm hitting tab. Now when I hit F5, we think we're going to filter out group A or group C, but the problem is if it's not in group C, it brings in the group A, and if it's not in the group A, it brings in group C. So we don't want to say or here, we want to make this an and. To do that, I would need to add another field here, group, and say not equal to group A, and remove it from down here. F5 to run. And let's look at this over an SQL view. I'll need to reformat this. And with this reformatted, the first thing I noticed is we have group in here twice because I didn't uncheck the visible checkbox. So we'll remove that here. Then we've got our from, our order by is all the same. The new thing is the where. And here we have our not equal with that exclamation point stays the same. Our ands and our ors, those work just as we would expect here. Now, because I have and logic and not, it can be a little confusing here. We're going to look at some ways later on that might be a little easier to understand. The important things to remember from this is our where, we have got our double quotes for our field name and single quotes for our parameter value or the thing we're looking for. Let's change this to equals group C, hit F5 and run it. And now let's save our query. We're going to make this one ODB20 query group C sorted. Going to close this, save our database. Thank you.